It will take place in stages. First, the Mahdi will unite the Islamic world. And when Jesus a.s. returns, the Christians and Jews will become Muslims. Thus, there will be only one religion left on earth. In one verse referring to this, Allah says, I take shelter in Allah from the Satan. Before you die, not a single person will be left who doesn't believe in you. Everyone will have faith, even including the Eskimos in the North Pole. The Quran states this quite clearly. It refers to the Prophet Jesus a.s., a sign of reckoning. It refers to the Prophet Jesus a.s., he, and says that when he comes, he is a sign of reckoning. His coming is a portent of doomsday at the same time. Allah says, referring to the Prophet Jesus a.s., I will make those who believe in you superior over non-believers right up until doomsday. We can see quite clearly in the hadith and from verses that he will return. We can clearly see that Islam will rule the world from verse 55 of Surah An-Nur. This is an explicit verse and there are very clear explanations. We can see from both the hadith and from the verses that Islam will rule the world. The story of Solomon a.s. and Dhulqarnain a.s. also indicate the global rule of Islam. That part about Dhulqarnain describes the global dominion of Islam. These two were the greatest powers in the world at that time. And so it will be again. The Quran indicates this. If a subject appears in the Quran, that means it will certainly come about, inshallah. Allah puts them in so that people can adopt them as role models, inshallah. This is the law of Allah, the law of Allah in the Quran.